Welcome back to another video. So many of you have asked for a guide that would help you to avoid investing in potentially problematic lenders that will eventually get suspended and your investments will get locked. This is obviously a more advanced topic, so thanks for all the coffees that allowed us to create this video. Today, I will give you 7 tips that will help you avoid investing in potentially risky lenders, and we will also look at some findings from my analysis of 155 million euro that several marketplaces are aiming to recover. My name is Jakub from P2P Empire, and on this channel we are all about maximizing the returns and safety of your P2P investments. If you want to become a more educated investor and learn more about how you can make money by investing in loans, consider subscribing and also hit the like button to not miss any further videos. Before we start, I shall point out that this is not a piece of investment advice. P2P lending is risky, and as I am recording this video, there are more than 155 million euro of investors' funds in recovery on 6 different P2P marketplaces. If you decide to invest in loans, you have to take responsibility for your actions and be aware of the fact that you might lose some money. Alright, so let's get straight to the 7 points which I believe will significantly increase the protection as well as the liquidity of your portfolio. Just a reminder, this video covers investments in lending companies that operate mainly within the payday loan sector or lend money to small and medium-sized businesses. In this video, we won't be covering the recovery of funds from P2P lending sites like Bondora or NeoFinance, nor the recovery of investments on crowdfunding platforms like EstateGuru or CrowdEstate. We will be only talking about P2P marketplaces that allow you to invest in loans from various lending companies. Alright, so as soon as you decide to invest in payday loans, you have to be able to evaluate the lenders. One task you should not miss is the review of financial results for the last fiscal year. The marketplace should be able to provide you with audited reports in English for all their lending partners. What you also want to monitor is the financial performance of those lenders during the year. It's not uncommon that especially larger financial groups also share a quarterly performance report of their loan book. If they don't, you should be able to request it directly from the marketplace. Another best practice is to look up the management of the lending company and see whether you can get your hands on an interview with the CEO or founder. As a responsible investor, you want to educate yourself about the lending practices of the lending company to avoid investing in Wild West markets or into lenders that are extremely aggressive and often over-leveraged. Educating yourself about the lending practices of various lending companies is particularly important if you have a larger portfolio of several thousands of euros. It's also worth mentioning that you should retrieve information from non-sponsored media. If you're consuming sponsored content, you can be certain that you won't get the full picture. Another good practice is to avoid investments in marketplaces that are not able to protect your investments. A good marketplace is constantly monitoring the performance of their lenders and loan book and limits the exposure of their loans as soon as the quality decreases. Not so good marketplaces list anything just for the sake of making a commission from the lender. They don't care about you as an investor, and they don't mind suspending even the lenders with the largest loan books. Also keep in mind that if there is an overlap of shareholders between the marketplace and the lending company, and several lenders with the same owners have been suspended in the past, it's likely going to happen in the future as well. A good practice is also to be very selective when it comes to investing in lenders who fund their loans on various platforms. Several suspended lenders have funded loans in the past on platforms like Groupier, Yuvo, Bonster or Mintos. Keep in mind that those lenders might be frequently over-leveraged, which increases the risk of your investments. A benefit of this setup is actually that if you are an active investor, you can spot problematic lenders on one platform and avoid any further investments in the same lender on another platforms. This has also been the case with Monify on Yuvo and Vyventor. If you were quick and you read our newsletter and you were able to liquidate your investments on the secondary market on Vyventor before it was too late. Another good piece of advice is to avoid investments in yet unregulated markets. If you decide to invest in Africa or Southeast Asia, you really have to put a lot of trust into the lending companies. What you should know is that those markets are yet unregulated, which means that they are riskier and you should be very selective or avoid them completely. So the last tip I want to share with you is to not rely on risk weight listings for marketplaces. This is just another marketing tool to promote their lending companies. It's not uncommon that even well-rated lenders have been suspended both on Mintos or Vymantor, which makes the ratings rather useless. So now let's have a look at the actual total amount of funds in recovery from six various marketplaces. Note that it's extremely difficult to retrieve accurate data on this matter. We have used the latest Mintos AMA session, the Vymantor statistics page, the statistics page from Lendy, our latest interview with Iuvo, and data that we have directly retrieved from Bonster to aggregate our statistics. In the case of Groupier, we could not get our hands on the actual funds in recovery for individual lenders, which is something you should consider as well. So in total, there is at least 155 million euro in recovery on six P2P lending marketplaces. This number is likely higher as we couldn't get our hands on the funds in recovery from TooFinance. Also, we have not included data from FastInvest, which is another shady platform that doesn't share statistical data and refuses to process withdrawal requests of fellow investors. Investing on FastInvest and TooFinance should be certainly avoided. So out of 155 million euro, roughly 57% are on Mintos, 30% on Groupier, and the rest is split between Lendy, Vymantor, and relatively minor amounts for Iuvo and Bonster. Obviously, what you should consider is the ratio between the funds in recovery and the total outstanding portfolio. If we would consider the size of the platform, Groupier, Vymantor, and Lendy are way worse than Mintos. Now, you might be wondering whether you could avoid investing in countries where those problematic lending companies are active. Well, in this chart, you can see the 109 million euro of funds split into different markets. Note that we haven't included the funds from Groupier in this chart as we could not properly allocate the exact numbers to individual lenders and markets. The most problematic markets seem to be Poland, Armenia, Ukraine, and markets from Southeast Asia and Africa. This list also includes some European markets such as Kosovo, Spain, Netherlands, and Lithuania. If you look at the chart of the countries, you would think that payday loan lenders from Poland or Ukraine are rather risky. In this case, it is hard to generalize. It really comes down to the lending practices of individual lending companies and also the legal agreements between the platform and the lender. Many companies in Poland treat P2P investors as dumb money, which means that they take the money and don't repay it while continuing lending to borrowers. If you want to expose yourself to payday loans from Poland and Ukraine, Peerberry offers currently the safest option with interest between 10 and 11%. So far, Peerberry has a very good track record in monitoring its business partners and protecting investors' interest, which cannot be said about other platforms. The loan book of the top lending companies on Peerberry, which operate in Ukraine and Poland, has performed very well last year, which seems to not be the case for many other market players. Investing in those countries on other platforms should therefore be approached with caution. What I personally avoid is investing in Southeast Asian and African countries. Those markets are yet rather unregulated and their risk is higher than the offered return. If you would look at the data from a lender's perspective, you will get a chart like this. As for Groupier, we have aggregated the data due to the lack of available information. The next two biggest problematic lenders with the largest amounts in recovery are Finco and Capital Service. What many investors are often interested is the likelihood of any recovery of their investments. Well, I can give you my humble opinion on this one. Lendy and Vymantor seem to fail completely, so if you are affected, joining or starting a lawsuit should be your next step. Groupier has failed already, and investors will be likely able to recover at least part of their funds. In our latest interview with Ivan Carr, the CEO has shared the information that they are ready to repay as soon as there is a safe way to do it. This is likely going to be the case with a few more lenders as well. The only way to get there would be to wait for the result of the lawsuit against Groupier, which will hopefully result in a safe way to transfer the funds back to investors. The chances to retrieve investments from fraudulent projects originated by Groupier's lending companies, as well as investments in already failed lending businesses like Monify, are very slim. When it comes to Mintos, the platform will be able to recover some funds as they have reduced the funds in recovery quite a bit over the last 12 months. You can follow up on their AMA sessions to get updated on the latest developments. Be aware though that it may take several years to recover your investment. When it comes to investments on Iuvo and Bonster, I believe that they will be able to recover at least some of the investments as well. There is certainly room for improvement for both Bonster and Iuvo, to inform investors about the current situation of their funds in recovery. I think that the communication in this matter is not sufficient enough. So what are now the main takeaways from this video? Well, in order to avoid investing in problematic lenders, you have to be an active investor. If you're a passive investor, meaning you don't monitor your portfolio and you don't check the latest news on independent websites like p2pempower.com, you will lose money sooner or later. What we are seeing is that many investors start informing themselves when it's often too late. And if we warn you about potential red flags in advance, many fans of those platforms start looking for ways to discredit facts. There is really no shortcut to making money online. You have to take responsibility for your investments and do not rely on sponsored promotions. Keep in mind that with any investment, you bear the default risk. If you are not ready to take responsibility and think for yourself, perhaps investing money isn't the right thing to do. What you can do to minimize your risks is to also invest in established platforms with a good track record. Peerberry, Robocash, or Twino are a few platforms that offer fewer diversification options but way more stable returns in comparison to marketplaces with suspended lenders. Another takeaway is to avoid investing in lenders from the SME sector. If you really insist, Debitum Network seems to be doing the best job in monitoring the quality of the loan book and acting sooner than later when there is an issue. And if you want to avoid bad loans completely, you can also shift your investments towards secure debt on crowdfunding platforms like Estate Guru. So this video has been obviously made for more advanced investors or really anyone who likes to educate himself about this topic. If there is something you have learned from it, you can let us know by liking the video or commenting below. Also, if you want to learn more about P2P lending, you can head over to our P2P lending academy on p2pempower.com or read our in-depth reviews about P2P lending platforms that enable you to earn money online by investing in loans. So that's it from me today. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.